Since last evening, entire nation is in deep sorrow. The passion, poetry, statesmanship, vision, and leadership whose name was Atal Bihari Vajpayee is no more with us. Let us pay our tribute to the departed leader by observing 1 minute silence. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Thank you. Savitribai Phule, Pune University welcomes you to this symposium. For this panel discussion, we request Dr. V.M. Katoch to be the chair. Also request Shailaja Chandra ma'am, Dr. Kishor Patwardhan, Professor S. Ramaswamy, Dr. J.L.N. Shastri, Dr. Dhiman sir, Dr. Nesari sir, and Dr. Bhushan Patwardhan sir to be on the dais. Thank you. Friends, there is a relevance to remember Atalji in this symposium. Not only because of his slogan of Jai Vidyan, but his love and respect for Indian knowledge systems. In his own words from the poem Amar Aaga Hai, Koti Koti Aakular Udhayo Mein Sulag Uthi Hai Jo Chinagari, Amar Aaga Hai. इसी आग की दिव्य विभा में सप्त सिंधु के कलकछार पर सुर सरिता की धवल धार पर तीर तटों पर पर्णकूटि में पर्णासन पर कोटि कोटि ऋषियों मुनियों ने दिव्य ज्ञान का सोम पिया था जिसका कुछ उच्छिष्ट मात्र बरबर पश्चिम ने दया दान सा निज जीवन को सफल मानकर सर आंखों पर धार लिया था वेद वेद के मंत्र मंत्र में वेद वेद के मंत्र मंत्र में मंत्र मंत्र की पंक्ति पंक्ति में पंक्ति पंक्ति के अक्षर स्वर में दिव्य ज्ञान आलोक प्रदीपित सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम शोभित कपिल कणाद और जैमिनी की स्वानुभूति का अमर प्रकाशन विशद विवेचन प्रत्यालोचन ब्रह्म जगत माया का दर्शन कोटि कोटि कंठों से गूंजा जो अति मंगलमय स्वर्गिक स्वर अमर राग है अमर आग है कोटि कोटि आकुल हृदयों में सुलग उठी है जो चिनगारी अमर आग है अटल जी वी विल कीप दिस टॉर्च फॉरवर्ड विद दिस आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर भूषण पटवर्धन टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स अबाउट दिस सिंपोजियम
फर्स्ट लेट मी थैंक ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर अगेन असेंबलिंग हियर फॉर दिस सेकंड सिंपोजियम मेनी ऑफ यू are attending for the second time. Some of you are coming for the first time. When our university received this Center of Excellence tag from the Ministry of AYUSH, we decided that every year we'll have this national symposium. This is an effort wherein we take one focal theme and go deep in it with the help of experts. So this is a small, selective but high-powered gathering. This symposium is only by invitation, so we try to not exceed number by hundreds, and there are breakout sessions. Last year's theme was how AYUSH can play a role in envisioning and implementing the vision of Prime Minister of New India. That was the end. How it can be mainstreamed in the public health programs of our country. This year our theme is creating conducive environment for AYUSH research. When question of research comes in, especially related to AYUSH, several questions come in our mind. Today, on one side, we are looking at mind-boggling advances in science and technology, so-called advances in different systems of medicine, modern medicine, surgery, new drugs. On the other hand, even in the developed world, the way to look at health is rapidly changing with the onset of non-communicable diseases coming very rapidly and new challenges including the antimicrobial resistance coming up and the new insights in biology which is leading more to systems approach. The value of knowledge from Ayurveda, yoga and such other Indian knowledge systems is only getting more and more appreciated globally. There is no denial that research is required in this field. But what is research? How it is relevant to these systems? Which methodology we should follow? Why we are lacking in this behind? What we should do? Which path we should follow? There are several questions in our mind. Research happens in good universities or top universities because good brains are attracted. How can we attract better and better brains to Ayurveda and yoga? How can you create conducive environment so that research actually is facilitated in these institutions? And we could see that there are several role models in India and abroad who have done their bit in their own field. And in these 2 days, you will get glimpses from those people who have actually done it, who will present it. And the audience will challenge that. Audience will ask questions. And this is what the debate and discussion will finally lead to some kind of a consensus. That consensus could be in research methodology. What could be the epistemological sensitive research methodology? First of all, what is epistemological sensitive research methodology and how to evolve that? So there are several such questions will be addressed in next 2 days. We know that time is very short in hand. But that's why this high power gathering. And that's why we do a lot of preparatory work in advance. So everybody must have received a lot of mails from us with a lot of reading material. We are going to learn from those leaders who have actually created conducive environment in their own institutions and transform those institutions into something totally different, starting from IITs, IIMs, ICERs, or the Ayurveda institutions of new generation as well. So these are some stories, success stories. There could be some limitations which will be shared, and this is how we plan to progress in these 2 days. Before we start this panel discussion, I would like to extend what Girish started with. Because all of us are missing that leadership today, you know, and we are really saddened. But at the same time, we remember how that ministry came in existence. Indian systems of medicine leading to today's Ministry of AYUSH. And we have the first secretary of this department of Indian systems of medicine, which was led under the leadership of Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, late Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And the first secretary at that time who closely interacted with him is Mrs. Shailaja Chandra. I would like to request her, before we start panel discussion, to share a few memories in this regard. Shailaja Chandra.
Thank you, Bhushanji. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to say this. These stories will have been heard by two people in this room already. In the morning, Rama Vaidya ji asked me to tell exactly the same thing, and I expounded to the point that she said, come, you come as you are, don't even bother to change, and that is why I happen to be in the clothes that I'm wearing, so it's not appropriate. But for the sake of the man, let me go back to memories which you will be able to empathize with, because they have everything to do with Ayush. Bhushan, I must correct you, I was not the first secretary. The ministry, the department was set up in 1993. I joined much, much later. Three secretaries had preceded me. But you are right in saying that it really germinated into a flower only, I mean, into a plant and a flower in Mr. Vajpayee's time. It was really he who gave the encouragement, he who gave us the ability to flower the way we did. And the stories I tell you are nothing to do with my prowess, but my association with his style of administration, which is something which was very special, because I have worked with so many chief ministers and also seen at close quarters three prime ministers, four. And I can tell you about this gentleman, how different it was. I'll give you three examples and it'll strike a chord for sure. The first is the fact that when I took over, we wanted to do something special. So we set up a big, in Vigyan Bhavan, a traditional medicine in the year 2000. So it was called traditional medicine in the new millennium. And we had the Prime Minister on the stage, Mr. Vajpayee. We had Rahul Bajaj, who was the president of CII. We had Braspati Dev Triguna and the cabinet secretary and me. And I do remember, because it's nothing to do with his personality, but because he was so gracious towards Ayurveda, we did three things. We had bell plants, big ones, brought by Zandu and presented to everyone on the stage, because a bell is very special in Ayurveda. We also had the pharmacopoeia released by him tied up in Bhojpatra, which was also very special. We got shanks from Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the actual shank, but the one which is the other way around, I don't know what it is called in Ayurveda, but Devendra Truguna told me, wo aap PM saab ko de dije, so we gave that. So that is how we kicked off this traditional medicine in the new millennium, when ambassadors from all the countries had been invited, and it was really a grand show. Then as life went on and as times went by, the next thing was that I wanted to set up this traditional knowledge digital library. As you know, there are 54 texts which are recognized in Ayurveda. And we did feel, Dr. Mashelkar told me, he said, you're in Ayush and everything is being patented. You have to do something about this. So we got together with patent examiners, we got together with National Informatics Center, and we said, why don't we put all the knowledge of Ayurveda into a traditional knowledge digital library, all the formulations, the pharmacology, the toxicology, everything, the chemistry of that, and then give at the bottom a scanned stanza from Ayurveda, which says how it goes back. So nobody can say that this is an invention. This is Ayurveda of so many thousand years ago. So hundreds of these postgraduates in Ayurveda were recruited and they all sat and we began getting this together. But that was later. To get the approval to do this, I had doubts. I said, you know, this has been completely a sheltered thing which is in a situation where nobody has access to it unless you know Sanskrit, unless you're a scholar of Ayurveda. The world doesn't have it. We are going to open this in six UN languages. The minute it is opened up, I could not foresee what might happen. The whole thing might blow up in my face and people may just take the whole thing and say it is all our. You know, you can't predict. It's after all going into an international domain. So I felt this should be put before who? Your minister is not good, really high enough to take approval, because the international scene is beyond that. You can't explain it to Ministry of External Affairs. They will say, we don't understand what you're saying. So I said, let's take it to the cabinet. And Mr. Mashilkar said, let us take it to the cabinet. So Vajpayee ji was in the chair as prime minister, and this item came up for setting up a traditional knowledge digital library. And Pramod Mahajan ji, who is no more, was very much there, and he just suddenly said, why do you want to bring all this to the cabinet? What is this bringing it to the cabinet? My heart sank. I said, what am I going to reply? Why am I bringing it to the cabinet? It's all written. The importance is that you are opening up to the world, not just to India, something very precious, and you don't know the ramification. And sure enough, when I got shouted at, Mr. Mashelkar was there, but he couldn't intervene because it's the departmental secretary who has to take the call. So I just explained very, very systematically. I said, you know, there can be risks, there can be problems, and I thought that the cabinet is the highest level which can take a view that we are opening up something that belongs to India and there should be an understanding. So I still remember Vajpayee ji. He was just sitting like that, the principal secretary to his left.